Welcome back to SLS Trivia. I'm your host, Kaitlin Rogers, and today we're going to test your knowledge about the rocket that will enable a new era of exploration, America's deep space rocket, the world's most powerful rocket, the Space Launch System. As we speak, SLS is being built and rigorously tested to the highest safety standards to protect our most precious cargo, the astronauts. So, today's questions are all about safety. We can quiz if you want to. We can leave your friends behind, because your friends don't quiz, and if they don't quiz, well, they're no friends of mine. Everybody's taking the quiz. It's the safety quiz. Question one. To protect astronauts in case a problem occurs during launch, the Orion crew module atop SLS will be equipped with what? Critical issue abort option, emergency evacuation slide, or launch abort system? During launch and ascent, what's the astronauts' escape plan? What will keep them safe if a failure were to occur? In case of a problem during launch or ascent, the launch abort system will jettison astronauts in Orion safely away from SLS. The rocket on top of the rocket can activate within milliseconds, delivering the crew up to 1 mile in altitude before safely parachuting back to Earth. On to question number two. As a rocket is propelled upward, propellants can surge downward to the engines, causing powerful up and down vibrations. This phenomenon is most commonly referred to as what? The locomotion interruption, the pogo effect, or the Bouncy Castle Conundrum. During launch, G-forces can push additional propellants into the engines, causing the rocket to surge forward. The surge reduces engine pressure, creating a feedback loop of alternating, increasing, and decreasing thrust, causing the rocket to bounce. Because of the similarities with bouncing up and down on a pogo stick, engineers call this the pogo effect. These oscillations along the thrust axis of a rocket can be dangerous if they match the resonant frequency of the rocket's structure. Not only could this damage the rocket, but the alternating positive and negative G-forces in the crew module could be dangerous for the astronauts. To overcome this and ensure astronaut safety, the SLS rocket's four RS-25 engines have gas pressurized chambers, known as pogo accumulators, that act like shock absorbers for the propellants and regulate their flow into the engines. Fun fact, as we build new RS-25 engines for future missions, we're incorporating dozens of additively manufactured components. By 3D printing the pogo accumulator, we've eliminated more than 100 welds, reduced cost for the part by nearly 35%, and production time by more than 80%. Safe and efficient. How about that? Time for the final question of the day, Q3. Speaking of the RS-25, the engine previously supported which program? The Saturn program, the Space Shuttle program, or the Kerbal Space program? With more than 1 million seconds of hot fire experience, RS-25, which is the epitome of reliability, was selected to power the SLS core stage. But what program did it power before? We're not launching little green aliens like the video game Kerbal Space Program. We're launching humans. And that's why the SLS core stage will be powered by the proven RS-25, formerly known as the Space Shuttle Main Engine. As part of the shuttle program, the RS-25 supported 135 missions. So, there you have it. From the top of the rocket, to the bottom, and everywhere in between, we're doing everything to make sure SLS is as safe as possible. How'd you do? Let us know in the comments and make sure to share with your friends. For more about the Space Launch System, follow us on Twitter and Facebook and visit nasa.gov/SLS. Thanks for playing.